Dear student, today we are going to start our new chapter for NEET and JEE. Coordination compound. Many questions asked from this chapter, so carefully watch full video. Now first we will discuss which are not given in our book. Flexi dentate ligands. Flexidentate, yes. Some ligands has a dual nature. Sometimes it behaves like a monodentate and sometimes it behaves like a didentate. So ligands are first of all sulfato. As a ligand we are calling sulfato. Structure of sulfato is like this. And carbonato, COOO- carbonato. Here two sides have capacity to donate electron pair. I am giving you example Fe(H2O)4. SO4 is given. Suppose plus 2, 0, minus 2. So 0. In this case, it behaves like a didentate. Why? You can see. Here Fe2 plus. Generally, shape of coordinate complexes is generally octahedral, tetrahedral like this. So here four molecules of water and one sulfato is combining there like this. So here it behaves like a didentate. Understood? To complete the six coordinate covalent bond of Fe+2 ion. Fe+2 na 6 coordinate covalent bond thi form thai. But if Fe(H2O)5 and SO4 is given, so here in this case it behaves like a monodentate. Why? 5H2O is already present. So here our sulfato donates only one pair of electron to the metal. So in this case, which behaves like a monodentate. Here as a didentate. Here as a monodentate. So that is called a flexidentate ligand. This type of explanation is not given in our book. So store in your mind. What about carbonate? See, if carbonate is here and 4H2O is combining, so one carbonato forms a double bond. So here it behaves like a didentate. And what about this case? So 5H2O is already present. So only one oxygen donates electron pair. So here carbonato is a monodentate. Understood? And another example is EDTA, which is also flexidentate. Flexidentates, now everybody know, everybody understood the means donating capacity in different complexes. EDTA, when we take EDTA means ethylene diamine tetra acetato, here CH2 2 nitrogen, then CH2COO- CH2COO- CH2COO minus is donating electron pair to the metal. Charge of iridium is minus 4, but donor are 6, so which is a hexadentate ligand. But in some case it bears like a tetradentate also, and sometimes a pentadentate. In some case here actually 6 electron pair donates to the metal and form 6 coordinate covalent bond, but sometimes it is a tetradentate and pentadentate also. In our book actually which is the capacity wise hexadentate, but in some cases it behaves like a tetradentate, in some cases only pentadentate. So these ligands are we are calling flexidentate ligands. Now ambidentate, which are given in your book ambidentate ligands. MB tentate ligand. Whenever when we take up NO2 minus, which is given in our book nitrito N, whenever nitrogen is donating electron pair to the metal, in this case oxygen is not donating electron pair to the metal. So in NO2, whenever nitrogen is donating electron pair to the metal and forms coordinate covalent bond, so in this case which is nitrito and capital N, N means nitrogen is donating here. Sometimes oxygen, whenever oxygen donates electron pair, so nitrogen is not donating here. Whenever nitrogen is donating, then oxygen is not donating electron pair to the metal, so which is called nitrito O for oxygen. Like this HCN minus, HCN minus NCN, suppose NCS minus, sulfur is donating electron pair, so here which is called thiocyanate. Thiocyanate. And whenever nitrogen is donating electron pair to the metal, so which is isothiocyanate. Clear? Name of the ligand. This type of ligands. Ambidentate ligand means it has two atoms, has capacity to donate electron pair to the metal. But out of two, only one donating electron pair to the metal. Whenever sulfur is donating, the nitrogen never donates. Whenever nitrogen is donating, sulfur never donates in case of donating of nitrogen. So this type of ligand is called ambidentate. Now we are going to solve some MCQ. In one question, you can see how many questions asked for the 10 JEE. Very interesting question. Entity CrNH35, Cl and as a counter ion SO4, sulfate. Here sulfate is not ligand, which is counter ion. First question, give the name of complex compound, means coordination compound. Here charge of chlorine minus 1, amine 0, here will be 3 plus. In the nomenclature, first comes positive part, then negative part. So in positive part, metal with ligand, so ligand comes first in return, but ligand has two types, so according to alphabetical order, so pentaamine, chlorido, chromium, not eight. Entity is positive, so eight no left, only chromium, pentaamine, chloride, chlorido, chromium, Roman digit 3, then sulfate, not sulfato. Why? This is counter ion, not ligand. First question. My second question, find out primary valency and secondary valency. So primary valency of chromium is plus 3. If primary valency as means oxidation number also plus 3 of the central atom. What about secondary valency? So in this case Cr plus 3 here combining with we have to knowledge about it of the ligands. Amine is a monodentate. Yes. 5 amine is combined and 1 chlorido. So entity having charge plus 2 and by ionic bond sulfase is connected to neutralize the charge of entity. So here you can see our secondary valency means number of coordinate covalent bonds. So secondary valency is 6 and coordination number is 6. Secondary valency is equal to coordination number and primary valency is equal to oxidation number, same as what. Secondary valency coordinate covalent bond 6, so 6 and easily coordination number. How much coordinate covalent bond is formed? Fourth question, find out number of d electrons in d orbital. How many electrons are there in d orbitals? So in chromium, atomic number 24, 4s1 3d5 is electronic configuration of chromium. So when in the plus 3 case, 1 from 4s, valine 3 removed, then after here, 3d3. So this is our answer, 3d3. The electrons are there. Now, hybridization asked of chromium. Yes, chlorido is weak, but amine is strong, we know. Which are strong ligands? Amine, carbonyl, EN and cyanido are strong, capable to push up the electrons. But here, no need to push up the electron. Why? Already 2,3-D is vacant. So, 6 ligands are coming. So, D2, sp3 hybridization occurs. Another 6th question, magnetic property. Yes, there are 3 unpaired electrons, so by nature paramagnetic. 6th question, which is paramagnetic due to 3 unpaired electrons. Magnetic momentum, 7th question. Mu is equal to n into under root n plus 2. So 3 plus 2 means 5. 5, 3 is 15. So 3.87 Bohr magneton. This is magnetic momentum. Now geometrical shape, 8-1. octahedral. You see, geometrical shape is asked octahedral. My ninth question. How much iron occurs during ionization? So Cr inside entity part never ionizes. When we dissolve into water, so ionic part will be ionized. As ionic bond is combined with it, one positive, one negative. So two ion occurs. My tenth question. Now it gives recipient with Agn of zinc. No. Ag gives recipient with chloride. But here chloride is inside. No PPT of AgCl occurs. Now 11th question. It gives recipient with barium chloride. Yes. Sulfur is counter ion. Combines with barium, and barium sulfate is insoluble in water, gives PPT with the barium chloride solution. So this type of question asked in exam. Only one entity, 11 questions. I hope you are enjoying my lecture. Now we are going to EAN. This is new for us, effective atomic number. We are going to effective atomic number. EAN means effective atomic number. This number gives stability of a complex compound. How to define EAN number of a central atom? Suppose FeCl6-4 is given. We have to find effective atomic number of the Fe. Here minus 6, so here will be plus 2. First of all, we have to find the atomic number of Fe. It's 26. And then after, here 26 electrons. But in the case of Fe plus 2, there are 24 electrons. So in Fe plus 2, number of electrons are 24. Then we have to count electrons which are coming from the ligands. So we know one cyano ligand donates 2 electrons to the Fe 2 plus ion. You can see. So how many cyano? 6. So 2 into 6. So 12 electrons are coming. So total is now 36. So which is the effective atomic number? And Z36 is of krypton. The Fe, after Fe, next element is of krypton. So it is a stable. 24 electrons check. 12 gain કરી લે એટલે ઇલેક્ટ્રોન Fe પાસે ટોટલ 36 થઈ જાય એટલે ઇન ક્રિપ્ટોન ઇટ ગેટ્સ લાઈક અ ક્રિપ્ટોન ટાઈપ ઓફ સ્ટ્રક્ચર સો વિચ ઇઝ અ સ્ટેબલ ઇન ધ આયન વી હેવ ટુ કાઉન્ટ નંબર ઓફ ઇલેક્ટ્રોન્સ ધેન કમિંગ ઇલેક્ટ્રોન્સ ફ્રોમ લિગેન્ડ ટોટલ ઓફ ઇટ ઇટ ગિવ્સ ઇફેક્ટિવ એટોમિક નંબર સિમ્પલ એટોમિક નંબર ઇઝ ધેટ ધીસ ઇઝ effective atomic number. Now next question. If FeCn6-3 is taken, So here will be plus 3. In Fe 26 electron, but in case of plus 3, there are 23. So 23 electrons incoming from 6 ligand are 12. So here effective atomic number is 35. It is near about to 36, but top, which is less stable than FeCN 6-4, why? Here completely configuration is not like Krypton. In NiCO4, tetracarbonyl nickel, here I am giving you reason why nickel here combining with only 4 ligand, why it's not combining with 6 ligand. So with help of it we can say 0 0, nickel having 28 charges 0, so 28 electrons in outermost orbit. So near about inert element is the krypton. So getting 36 electron, how much is needed? 8. So 28 plus 8 gives 36. So 1 carbonyl gives 1 electron pair, and 4 carbonyl gives 4 electron pair. So total 8. Only 6 are combining, or only 4 are combining. This is the trick. This is the trick. Now we are going to discuss about the ligands. Type of ligand, density, how many electron donates to the metal, yes, about it. First of ligand, charge of ligand, name of ligand. And donor atom in the ligand, which is donor atom in the ligand. We have to knowledge about it. One by one, H2O charge is 0, aqua, otherwise aqua. Sometimes aqua in reference book it appears, otherwise aqua. Here which atom is donating electron pair? Oxygen is donor. Now NH3 charge is 0, neutral. Amine, here donating atom is nitrogen, is donor. What about CO? Charge is 0. As a ligand we are calling the carbonyl. Here not oxygen, but carbon is donor. Carbon is donating electron pair to the metal. NO, charge is 0. Nitrosyl, NO is a nitrosyl. Here nitrogen atom donates electron pair. All these are neutral and monodentate. What about CS? CS, CO in CS. Here in CS, sulfur is donating electron pair. Name thiocarbonyl. CO is only carbonyl, CS is a thiocarbonyl. Carbonyl, thiocarbonyl. Then NS. Here NO, here is NS, neutral. Charge is 0. NS, thionitrosyl. Nitrosyl, thionitrosyl. Here donor atom is nitrogen, not sulfur. Yes. Then C5H5N. Charge is 0. This is actually pyridine. CH, 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 CH. P, Piridinna. Piridinna. P-Y, insulter. Then P-Y comes, means pyridine, which is neutral by charge and monodentic. Only nitrogen, one atom, donates electron pair. Pyridinna. Then CH3NH2. Charge is zero. Methyl amine. Yes, here nitrogen is the donor. Nitrogen atom donating electron pair. Now dinitrogen. Yes. Charge is zero. Dinitrogen is donor. This one labeling it out of two. Here, otherwise here. Dinitrogen, which is ligand. And here donor is the one nitrogen atom out of two, not both. Dioxygen, yes, which is also ligand, charge is zero, neutral. Dioxygen, we are calling as a ligand. Dioxygen, yes, in written like this, here donor is the oxygen atom. Now, pH 3, we are called charge is zero. Phosphine, here phosphorus is donating electron pair. Phosphine. Then urea. Then after urea, NH2CONH2, charge is zero, which is urea. In the urea, donor atom is the oxygen. Here oxygen is donor, not nitrogen. This is also monodentate. Only oxygen donates electron pair, not nitrogen, in the urea. Now thiourea. I think you have to take the screenshot of these compounds. Urea, then after thiourea. Urea, then thiourea. Only one difference there in thiourea. Sulfur is here. NH2SONH2. Charge is zero. Thiourea. Oh, now place over S. Sorry. Here donor is a sulfur. Here oxygen, here sulfur. Now triphenylphosphine. Here is phosphorus. In our book, it's given like this, PH3P. Charge is zero. One phosphorus has 5 electrons. Three combines with phosphorus, two are remaining. So phosphorus donates electron pair to metal, monodentate. And phosphorus is donor here. Triphosphine, PH3P. Then acetone. Charge is zero. Acetone. Here donor is the oxygen. Now ethylene diamine. CH2 CH2 NH2 NH2. Charge is zero. Ethylene diamine. Otherwise ethane 1,2 diamine also. Insert EN. Here two donors. Two nitrogen atoms donates at a time. So didentate. Here single single atom means monodentate. Two N means didentate. Donates two electron pair to the metal. So So this is didentate term. Now what about diethylene triamine? Diethylene triamine. In diethylene triamine, in salt, here is abbreviated from SEN. Here is di-in. This salt form, diethyl triamine. Here NH, CH2, CH2, NH2. Here CH2, CH2, and NH2. Ethyl 2 times and amine 3 times. Diethyl triamine. Here 3 nitrogen atoms donates electron pair. Tridentate. Here 3 nitrogen atoms donor. 3 nitrogen atoms. Now, then here it is neutral ligand by charge. Triethylene tetraamine. Triethylene tetraamine. In salt, it is a triene. Here, 4 nitrogen atoms are donor. Structure of it. Triethylene. CH2, CH2, 1 times NH. CH2, CH2, NH2. Here is NH. You can see 1, 2, 3 and 4 amine. Tetraamine. And 3 times ethylene. So triethylene tetraamine. Which has 4 donors. 4 nitrogen. So tetradentate ligand. This one is our tetradentate ligand. Now we will discuss about it more in next lecture. Till then, bye. Take care. I hope you are enjoying my lecture.